Hey everybody, it's your boy, the Tatumeister here. We're here at the final Hilda review. Now, I'm going to go through each episode here and give you my thoughts on each and then give you an overall thoughts on it. I know I haven't posted a video in a while. There's been reasons for that. One, because I feel like the last video I posted was kind of, not that good, and I felt bad about it for a while. Also, I was going through a lot mentally and I had to go get help. But now I'm back, and I'm going to be posting more videos next year. I'm going to make a trailer for upcoming videos and for Goodbye DCU. I'm going to finish that. So, yeah, so let's review the final season of Hilda. So, yeah, it's been quite a journey to get to this point, let me tell you. 3 seasons of Hilda and a movie. Wow. I am still going to review all the books, but... yeah, let's review this final season, shall we? Okay, so we're going to go through each of these episodes here. So the first episode is called Train to Toppidan. Hilda and the gang take a train to Toppidan to visit Great Astor for a relaxing holiday. Now, the first episode of season 3, I think, is a good start. Now, not a lot really happens in it, but really it's just a world-building episode. And it really gets you back into the spirit of the show. I really like it a lot. I'm going to give this one an 8 out of 10. Very good. I liked it. Very good introduction. That's all I'm going to say without spoilers. So, Chapter 2, The Ferryman. Convince the fairies to exist and tell Hilda's next investigate around town to cover probably mystery involving her own family. Now, this is basically similar to Season 1, Episode 1 and 2. This is a continuation of Episode 1 of Season 3, the season finale, the premiere. And yeah, it's almost as good. I give it an 8 out of 10. I mean, it's just a continuation from that episode. And yeah, it does a good job. I like it. So, next up we have... the Giant's Lair. Yeah, this one's really good. Ancient fir tree transports Hilda and the Woodman to an alternate universe where feud rages between girls and almighty Giant's Lair. So yeah, it's an alternate timeline, such alternate universe kind of deal. And yeah, I really dug this one a lot. This is getting a 9 out of 10. This was a fantastic episode. It brought me back to the reminder, remind me of 80 year night or something. The episode for season 2 where they traveled in time, which she referenced, by the way, in that episode. But yeah, I liked it a lot. Very, really good story. Like, very, really done. It's just awesome. You gotta watch it. It's a great episode, truly. Next we have probably the weakest episode of the season, but still pretty good. The Laughing Mermaid. The Laughing Merman, Chapter 4. Season 3, Episode 4. After their Phyllis Barrow stones dubbed with the Freaky Friends, Hilda, Fred, and David resolved to have their most ordinary river trip imaginable. Now, I don't particularly hate this episode, but I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. It's the weakest one of the season, and arguably probably the weakest one of the show, I'll be honest. This episode really does feel like off. It just doesn't feel like it's connected to anything, and it doesn't even have that good of a story. But I give it props for giving development for Hilda and the new character, the girl that traveled with them. I like some parts of it. I find it kind of funny at points, and it has some good visuals. But as a whole, I do think it's the weakest episode of the season. Not bad by any means, but it didn't really do it for me. I was just waiting for the next one, which the next one is awesome. I'm excited to talk about that one. So, okay, the next one's called Chapter 5, The Job. When Hilda's father comes for a surprise visit, she joins him on a mysterious errand to the castle ruins on behalf of the shady man who's the polecat. Now, as soon as I found out Hilda's dad was going to show up in this season, I'm like, okay, I'm ready for that episode. I'm ready. Bring it on. Like, finally, we're going to see Hilda's dad. And was it worth the hype? I guess. Yeah, I'm going to give this one a 9 out of 10. Yeah, I think it was. The Job is a really great episode, for real. It is very well done. It brings back Hilda's dad, which we never saw before up to this point. Which does beg the question, where the heck was he this whole time? Why wasn't he seeing his daughter? What was so important that he wasn't hanging out with his daughter? Okay, I don't know. But they never really answered that question. But for the most part, The Job is a fantastic episode, and I really dug it. It was nice to see moments with him and her and her dad finally. You know, her and her mom and the troll. And it was nice to see all this stuff. It was really cool. Next we got Chapter 6, The Forgotten Lake. Oh, man. So, Forgotten Lake, this episode is probably the most violent, most scary episode in this show, legitimately. Like, I was at the end of my seat watching Forgotten Lake. Like, For a G-rated show, they got a lot away with a lot with this episode. Like, it got pretty dark. Like for example, I don't know if I want to spoil it, but well, there's a couple parts in here where I'm like, oh my gosh, like really for a G-rated like TVY7 show, like they really got away with a lot with Forgotten Lake. Like, I guess because it's the last season, they were able to do a little more. But Forgotten Lake got pretty dark. Like, it got scary and dark. I'm not sure what I'm gonna say without spoilers, but my gosh, that episode was awesome. Forgotten Lake gets a 10 out of 10. Honestly, Forgotten Lake gets a 10 out of 10. This episode is flawless. Like, it is perfect. Forgotten Lake is awesome. Honestly, perfection. And then Chapter 7, Frank's Frequencies. So this is the penultimate episode of the series. I'm gonna give it 9 out of 10. Strange Frequencies is really good. Very suspenseful build-up. I really like the plot of it with them trying to help out the Tontus, the Nessie. I really like Frida's development in it. I really like David and everybody. It was really well done. Really liked it a lot. Really funny, really good. And then here it is. The series finale of Hilda, The Fairy Isle, Chapter 8. Season 3, Episode 8. The final episode of What did I think of it? Well, it's a 10 out of 10. I mean, yeah, no shit. Arguably, this could be the best episode of the show. Arguably. Bro, I cried at one part. It was. Fairy Isle is arguably one of the best cartoon finales I've ever seen. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I was worried they weren't gonna stick the landing. I was so worried, like, after Mountain King, how are they gonna make a better ending than that? But they somehow did. Now, I know my friend Fishy doesn't really agree with me. He thinks that, Mountain King is the better finale. But as an epilogue finale, this wrapped up everything else. Then the only gripe I have with this finale, the only gripe I have with this final season, is that Aalborg wasn't in the season a lot. That's about the only gripe I have with this season. I feel like Aalborg didn't get a lot of screen time in this. Well, he didn't get any screen time in season 3, but I feel like he should have had some screen time because I know he retired and I know I guess he left Trollberg or whatever. But I mean, so did Raven. Oh, was that a spoiler? Well, he's in the trailer. Yeah, I'm gonna say it. Raven comes back in the final part of the final episode. Raven does come back. Yes. Granted, it's a very small scene at the end, but yes, Raven does have one epic scene at the end, and it's awesome. I'm happy Raven finally came back for one last episode. I was very satisfied with that. And they referenced almost every single character in that last 5 minutes. It was freaking amazing. I was blown away. I was like, heck yeah. Freaking dope. But yeah, guys, Fairy Isle is one of the most beautiful cartoon finales you'll ever watch. And while it does have its flaws, like with the villain, mind it, I got some screen time, neither did Aalborg. I feel like as a whole, the finale is perfect. Pretty much as good as they could have done. Like, it is wonderful. And I kind of wish they kept going because that. It just makes me miss. It's going to make me miss the show. It really is. But. So, yeah, what do I give this season overall? I mean, what do I give the final season? I'm going to give it 10 out of 10. You know what? I don't even care. Listen. Even in counting the mermaid episode, as a whole, this show is phenomenal. Like, as a whole, I really don't care. I feel like season one's still my favorite, but season two and three are just as good. Very freaking close. They are very freaking close. I mean, all three of them are very close to me, to my heart. And yeah, season three is no different. I feel like this season really just stuck the landing really well. The only two gripes I have is Aalborg, and yeah, they didn't. It wasn't very long. It should have been 13 episodes like the other two seasons. They would have fleshed out some things. It's fine. You know, whatever. I guess 8's enough. It's fine. I guess Netflix wanted to get it over with. I don't know why Netflix is such a hate bonus of fucking cartoons. Okay. But okay, for what it is, that finale, that Fiery Isle, is like the best episode of the show. So, you know what? I don't even care. Like, legitimately. I mean, yeah, they stuck the landing. The Fiery Isle is the best episode. I'm gonna go far and say that, because it just wraps up everything with a nice neat bow. It does everything perfectly. It doesn't. Again, the only thing is Aalborg, which, again, Aalborg's not really a super fan favorite anyway. I think he's a fun character to me, but I get why people didn't want him in this season. I guess he pissed a lot of people off in the Hilda community. I understand. But it would have been nice to have one scene with him, okay? I don't know. It would have been nice to have one scene. I don't know. I'm just saying. But Anyway, so that's my review on Halo Season 3. I hope you all enjoyed that. I'm going to edit the crap out of it, but yeah, that's about it. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next year. Marceline the Vampire Queen.
Marceline the Vampire Queen. Marceline.
All right. See y'all later.